What is the best grammar for learning Greek on your own, and what else do you need? Well, those are the questions we're going to look at in this video today. I know that a lot of you want to learn Greek and that you don't want to pay for somebody to help you or anything like that, so this video is for you. Let's get into it. Studying Greek alone is hard, and it's made even more difficult by selecting the wrong grammar to help you get started. So one of the things I want to save you is at least let's talk about getting you the right grammar so that you've got at least the material you need to make good progress in your Greek. Because if you don't get the right grammar, there's a good chance you'll just find it too difficult, more difficult than it needs to be, and it's already hard enough, and you'll crash on the rocks. And I don't want that for you. I want you to be successful in learning Biblical Greek. Hi, I'm Daryl Burling from Master New Testament Greek, and I help people like you with the tools, habits, and system to master the Greek of the New Testament. If you're interested in learning Greek, then hit the button down below that says like, and hit the subscribe button as well. And then if you see a little notify bell, make sure you click that as well, and that way you'll get notified when new videos come out. Like I said, in this video, I want to help you learn Greek on your own. Now, this is a challenge. Not everybody can do this. In fact, most people who start out, and I was included in this, when I first started learning Greek, I started on my own and I didn't get very far. So you're probably going to be like me. And I understand how that works, right? You've got a job, you've probably got children, you've probably got ministry responsibilities, you've got all sorts of other burdens and responsibilities that make it hard. So it's a hard job and you've got to be really motivated and have the time to put into it. And honestly, most people don't count the cost. And to help you with that, you can check out this video here, which is really designed just to give you a bit of an idea of what it takes to learn Greek, just to help you get yourself started. And of course, I want to encourage you also to download my free roadmap to mastery at masterntgreek.com/roadmap, and that will at least help you sort of lay out the process and what's involved as well. There are a number of things that can really help you when you're learning Greek alone, and really that's one of the things I want to help you with this video. At the end of this video, I'm going to talk about some of those things in addition to getting the right grammar. But for the start, let's just start by talking about what grammar is the best grammar to get a hold of to get you started learning Greek on your own. Here's the thing. When it comes to grammars, publishers tend to cater for professors, Greek professors, people who teach Greek in a classroom environment. And that means then that they're going to be looking for what is going to help the classroom environment for the most part. And this makes sense, right? Because most of the people who recommend Greek grammars are the people teaching Greek, right, to other people. You don't know what Greek grammar to get unless someone who's teaching it tells you this is a good grammar. And unless you come here, for instance, and hit the subscribe button so you don't miss a video, unless you come here and look at this, then you're not going to know what grammars are the best ones and so on. And not only that, but also it tends to be those professors who are the ones who are writing Greek grammars. And of course, they're writing Greek grammars based on what they're doing in their classroom. So you can see how most of the Greek grammars that you buy on the market today are really designed around the classroom. It makes, you know, total sense to understand that when you look at it that way, right? So that this means then that there's going to be a lot of grammars that you're going to run into that you're going to find on the market that expect you to have a professor, a regular schedule or assignments that you're going to have to hand in. You're going to need someone who's going to grade your work. They expect you to have someone's going to be doing that, which is why you don't find answer keys in a lot of Greek grammars. They're going to often have a carrot or a stick, depending on what it is in terms of grades or a good outcome that they're trying to offer you as well. A lot of seminaries now actually don't even require Greek because it's just too hard for students. And so if you're embarking down this track, know that many have gone before you and have not been successful, which is even with a stick or a carrot, it's not been as successful as those seminaries would like it to be. They'd also normally expect you to have a cohort of other people going through the same experience who can encourage you and study with you. And then finally, they will always tend to be thinking in terms of semester limitations, which is to say that they expect that you're going to be working through about a 16-week semester, and they're going to try and cram beginning Greek into that period of time. Now, that means then that most Greek grammars work to a fairly consistent and similar structure, which is that classroom environment, which means then that not every grammar is ideally suited for learning Greek on your own. If you want to learn Greek on your own, you're going to have to find a grammar that is a little different to those run-of-the-mill classroom-oriented grammars. But today, there are a number of really good Greek grammars that provide for you, you know, material that goes beyond what you're going to need in a classroom. There are a number of grammars today that are going to give you really good detailed explanations without making it overly complex, but just giving you a good amount of detail. Again, one of the things with classroom grammars, they tend to be quite light in terms of explanation because they expect the professor is going to lecture over this, and then all you need is some notes to go away when you go home with and you'll be able to figure it out. But some of these modern grammars now have got not only good explanations, but they also are very clear about this is what you need to know. This is what you need to learn. Here's how you want to learn that. They'll also have exercises for you to work through inside the grammar themselves. And often they'll even have answer keys available so you can work through the answers to the exercises on your own as well. And this is the kind of thing that is going to make a huge difference for learning Greek on your own. And not only that, you're also going to benefit from some additional help, such as videos and perhaps vocabulary that's set out on electronic form in some way, so that you can actually learn them on your mobile device rather than having to write physical flashcards out, or worse yet, go and buy physical flashcards for a particular Greek grammar. You don't want to do that if you can possibly help it. So these are some of the things that you want to look for in a beginning Greek grammar. Now, before I go on and talk about some of the grammars out there that you might consider for beginning Greek on your own, let me just ask you again, if you're getting value out of this, hit the thumbs up button. It does help the YouTube algorithm find these videos and help other people find them as well. So let's get into a number of grammars. And it's possible that as you're listening to this, you're saying, hey, this grammar is on my shelf. Maybe this would be good for a beginning Greek course. And so I'm going to go through 8 grammars in this video. And I'm just going to, these aren't all the grammars that are on the market by any stretch of the imagination. They're not even all of the ones that, you know, that I've reviewed on this channel. So there's lots of Greek grammars out there. These are really the ones that are going to be either the best for beginning Greek on your own, or that you might think might be the best for beginning Greek on your own. Okay, so let me just go through these quickly. Let me just run these 8 off. First one is Dobson's Learn to Read New Testament Greek. And I don't have copies of all of these here, but you'll figure it out as we go. Benjamin Merkel and Rob Plummer's Beginning with New Testament Greek, which is a really good one. There's also Rodney Decker's Reading Koine Greek, which is one I like. There's Croy's Grammar, which I don't have a copy of right here. There's Mounce's Basics of Biblical Greek, another very popular one. Black's Learn to Read New Testament Greek, I think it's called. Dana Harris's New Grammar, which came out last year, which I did a review of. And then Danny Zacharias's Biblical Greek Made Simple. Now, I've chosen these 8 because they're a mixture of either really good sort of for self-learning, or they are so popular that you might think, well, this must be a good one to learn with. And I want to make sure that you know that some of these are actually not very good for learning on your own. So for example, Mounce's Basics of Biblical Greek is not a good example for learning on your own. The reasons being that really generally, he provides you a lot of detail in here. And most people, when they get into Greek, they want to master every concept in the chapter. And he gives you way too many concepts that you're going to be able to master, and you're never going to succeed. You're going to have this perfectionist syndrome, typically, and you're going to just clock out at some point, and it gets too hard, and you won't be able to remember things. And so you'll just give up. And this is one of the things that we see with Mounce. I learned using Mounce. I really like it. I think it's a great grammar for refreshing your Greek, but I wouldn't use it if you're learning Greek for the first time on your own. In addition to that, it also has an additional workbook, and it's not that easy to find the answer key. So there is an answer key online. You can Google it and find it, but it doesn't come with a workbook, and they expect that you're going to have a professor to explain it. But it does have pretty good explanations. The problem is, of course, it's just too much information to take in on the first time. Another example of a grammar that people might think this must be a good one for learning alone is David Allen Black's Learn New Testament Greek. I can't remember the name of it, I'm sorry. The black one. Anyway, this one here. So if you get that one, it's okay. It's a little dated now in terms of deponency. It needs richer explanations. Again, it's a classroom grammar, so it expects that you're going to have a professor who's going to lecture through the material, and then, of course, you're able to sort of go home with the book, and that's your notes, and you don't need to worry about it too much. There's also no answer key, and really, this is a book that is best matched to a classroom rather than sort of learning on your own. Also, Croy, this one, this is a little bit dated now. I wouldn't go down the track with this one. It's got no answer key, and again, it's got some strengths, but again, this is a classroom grammar, very much, very much a classroom grammar, not designed for learning Greek on your own, so not one that I'd recommend. And of course, Dana Harris's very good grammar. I really like Dana Harris's grammar. It's got very good explanations in it, but it's very dense, a little bit like Mounce's Basics of Biblical Greek. It's probably a little bit over the top for somebody who's learning Greek on their own. It gives you too much to try and learn, and particularly I think chapter 2, introducing you to verbs, there's a lot to learn there without a lot of tangible kind of takeaway knowledge. So this is not a great grammar for beginning Greek on your own, but it is a great, great book. And it also does have a separate workbook, which is also a downer because it means you have to buy additional material to be able to learn it on your own. And that's just a negative in my mind. And that's not Danny Harris's fault. It's just the choice the publisher makes. Okay, so those are four that I think are popular that people might think, hey, this would be a great grammar to learn on my own. They're not. Okay, so I would avoid Mounce, Black, Croy, and Harris, and just put those aside. Now, they can be good as a reference grammar. So if you get one of the next four that I'm going to talk about, then these would be the one, then those would be helpful as a reference grammar with a bit more information, particularly something like Mounce or Harris, which have a bit more explanation and they've got really good detailed descriptions in them. So those are good ones to have as a secondary grammar, but not a primary grammar. So that leaves then the four that I held up just before: Decker, Dobson, Merkle and Plummer, and Danny Zacharias's Biblical Greek Made Simple. Now, of these, the top two choices, I'm not going to give you one of these, but I'm going to just give you two that I think are the top of the pile. And one of those is Rodney Decker's Reading Koine Greek. This continues to just impress me, this grammar, every time. I mean, and even Master New Testament Greek students routinely explain and say that this grammar is just a really good grammar. It's got very good explanations. It's not overly dense, it doesn't give you too much technical data, but it does give you good explanations. And as you know, as you can see, it's got quite a lot in it. It's got all the it's got all of the exercises in here, it's got answers in here, and it's pretty good. This is really, in some ways, one of the top grammars on the market today, particularly for self-study. This is just a good all-round grammar, probably one of the best of the best. Now, the problem with this, of course, is that it's still, you know, 500-ish pages. It's still a lot of, you know, still quite dense in a lot of reading, which is why really the other one I often recommend is beginning with New Testament Greek. And really, one of the key differences, I mean, these are very similar in so many ways. There's some distinctions between them, but they're not that significant. The big difference between these two is really that if you go to beginninggreek.com, you'll get all the videos for every chapter of this grammar for free, right? They're all there, publicly available on the website, including songs and vocab and all sorts of things. So this then sets this one apart in a number of ways. First of all, you've got all those free resources, but secondly, again, look at the depth of this. There's not that many pages by comparison to Rodney Decker's grammar, and this means that this doesn't give you too much information. I found in my work so far, this is almost about right in terms of the amount of information you need. However, if you did need more detail, either Rodney Decker, Mounce, or perhaps Harris, either of those three would be a really good, and those are the ones I tend to recommend to pair with beginning with New Testament Greek. But this is probably the best read Greek, learn Greek on your own grammar that you can get out there. So it's not overly dense, it's about the right depth and density. It gives you loads of extra resources, and that makes all the difference. And again, if you're going to get, say, Mounce, or you're going to get Dana Harris's grammar and you want the videos, you go buy those. So you're paying hundreds of dollars for beginning Greek, where all of that is part of the purchase price of this. So it's a no-brainer in that sense. This is a good all-round grammar, and I heartily recommend it. But that brings me to two kind of surprise options that are well worth considering. If you don't have those, but you already have these two, then that might be well worth working with. The first one is Dobson's Learn New Testament Greek. This is a really well-designed grammar. It is designed with lots of short, easy exercises, and it's very practical. This is one of the things I really like about this grammar, is it's super practical. It's not, it does have an answer, the answer key with it. Sometimes, in fact, the answer key is a little bit too accessible. You'll have like Greek down one side and then the answers on the other. And I think that can be a little bit of not very helpful. But nonetheless, the answers are there. The exercises themselves are really simple. And this is a pretty good grammar. Now, the problem with this is it's about 50 chapters long, and you really want to do at least one chapter a week. You should be able to do two a week and keep up with this, hopefully, but you want to stay consistent. I'll talk about that in just a moment. But this is a really good grammar for working through on your own. So if you've already got this and you don't have one of the others, then to give this a go first and see how you go. The other one that's kind of a little bit of a surprise for me, the more I reflect on this, the more I kind of like this, and that is Danny Zacharias's Biblical Greek Made Simple. Now, what makes this a particularly good self-study grammar is it's not trying to get you to that reading Greek stage, which means that you can get to the stage where you're reading or working with the Greek with Logos Bible software relatively quickly, and then you can go through this a second time and get to that reading Greek stage. So this is a really interesting grammar. I like it. Now, the only thing, it doesn't have the answers in it, but I'll leave a link in the description below where you can get the answer key. It's all available on Danny Zacharias' website, and he's got some other resources there as well. So this has, again, got a number of videos and things like that with it that are going to make it a lot more accessible. The downside with this is that there's a lot of paradigms to learn, and that may be a bit of a downer, but nonetheless, I still think this allows you a graduated approach to learning Greek as well. You don't have to learn how to read Greek or even translate Greek. This will teach you how to use Logos to sort of work with the Greek for Bible study and for sermon preparation, and then you can continue to progress beyond that using the same grammar over a period of time as well. But again, this is just a really helpful, I think, grammar for self-study. So those are the four that I really recommend. And of those four, as I mentioned, probably my top one would be beginning with New Testament Greek, which is what we use in Master New Testament Greek as well. So there's another thing. If you did try this on your own and you did want to then join us for Master New Testament Greek, well, you've already got the grammar for it. So that would be the one that I recommend. Now, there are some other things you are going to want to think about if you're going to go through beginning Greek on your own. And I've made some videos about these, so they're all freely available, and this is just to sort of help you out and just to encourage you a little bit more as you're learning Greek on your own. First thing is, don't worry about getting it exactly right. The goal of going through each chapter of any given grammar is not to perfect the material in that chapter. The goal of every chapter is to understand the basics of the chapter and then move on, right? You've got to keep moving. The one thing that I want to encourage you to do as you learn Biblical Greek is set a timetable where you do a certain amount each week and stick to it. The most important thing is consistency, not speed, right? It doesn't matter if it takes you 2 years to get through beginning Greek. Hopefully it won't. But it's more important that you just keep taking progress, okay? Just keep making progress. That's the most important thing. And I made a video about this, which I'll link to just up here for you as well to watch. It's totally free. You don't have to pay for that at all. The other thing I want to encourage you with as you start into beginning Greek is that it's going to take four habits that, again, I'm going to leave a video link just up here for you to watch, which explains these four habits that you're going to need to get through any beginning Greek grammar and to really make that progress that you need to make on a week-by-week basis. Okay, the four habits you want to get into is, first of all, you want to learn your vocabulary and review your vocabulary every day. Vocabulary acquisition is a core and necessary part of learning any language, and that's just as much the case with Greek, in fact, if not more so, as it is with any other language. Okay, so focus on the vocabulary acquisition on a day-by-day basis. The second thing I want to get you to do is to write out the paradigms that you've learned in this chapter and in previous chapters pretty much, again, every day. Now, some of those paradigms you're already going to know, and that's great. Don't spend as much time on those, but focus on the ones you don't know as well. Master those so that when you do come to do the translation work, all the information you need is there in your head and you're able to translate the text without even having to think about what things are. You know, oh, that's a third person singular ending. Oh, that's a sigma aorist. That's a tense formative for an aorist verb. You know, those kinds of things. You want to know that automatically, and knowing your paradigms will help with that. But then there's another piece, and that is that you're building another section of the bridge, so to speak, which again is in that video, and that is that you want to really practice putting those endings and pieces together on the vocabulary you're learning, and that's where a parsing app like Parse Greek or Paradigm Master Pro really helps, because it allows you then to practice that process, and then when you come to the translation work, which is the fourth habit, you've already kind of got a lot of those habits and processes under your belt, so you're able to just keep taking consistent steps forward. Okay, so those four habits are going to be critical if you're going to learn Greek on your own. All right. So that's my summary of how to learn Greek on your own. I want to ask you though, if you've got one of these grammars or if you're planning on using one of them, let me know in the comment section below which one you're planning on using. I look forward to hearing from you there. And also if you've not used one of these and maybe you self-study using another one, let me know in the comment section below what you used and how you found it. Other people will also find that really helpful because then they'll know either what has worked for other people or what has definitely not worked for other people as well. And it will probably be that some of you may have tried even these ones that I recommend here and have not had great success. Let us know why in the comment section. What was missing? What could you have benefited from as well? The other thing I want to encourage you to do is if you are interested in getting a group of learners around you, which is one of the things that publishers expect you to have when they publish a beginning Greek grammar, a classroom of other students. If you want that, then go download my roadmap to mastery at masterntgreek.com/roadmap, and that way we can let you know when there's an opportunity to join the mastery membership or the community membership, and you'll be able to get straight in and get support from people in that community who are on the same track as you as well. So go ahead and do that, masterntgreek.com/roadmap. Finally, thank you so much for watching. And if there's anything you're interested in learning about how to learn Greek alone, leave it in the comment section below. I'd love to hear from you there as well. And I look forward to serving you in the next video. Until then, remember, it's about consistency. So keep taking small, consistent steps toward mastery. I'll see you in the next video. See you then.